So one of the things about a Roubaud vise is that when you crank the handle on the top, the opposite reaction is to and you have something in the top. Well, the opposite reaction is for the bottom to kick in towards the body of the bench or the supporting leg. And so it's impossible to stop it. It's just the way it is. So really the only rock solid way to do it is with the pin, you know, where the pin will actually just stop that wanting to kick in, or the way I'm going to do it, where I'm going to have a threaded mechanism that's going to arrest that. Now, the chances of you being 100% parallel all the time, you know, are pretty slim. And so what I'm doing is I'm making the arrangement here for my Acme threaded rod to have just a little bit of slop in here. Now, there's not going to be any adjustment between the two bushing guides. That's going to hold that Acme threaded rod in place. But as the vise kicks in, this line is going to raise up. It just has no it can't do anything but that. So when I've got here's my arrangement here that I've got is I've got this plate. This is just my retainer, and then inside here there's going to be another piece of 3/8 inch plate, and it's going to be softened off on the bottom, so as the thing kicks in it can rock slightly, and this is going to be free floating in here. So as the thing racks, it's going to allow some adjustment to keep from putting so much pressure on that screw through the two bushings. That's why I've got this 3/4 inch hole elongated. Now I'm getting ready to weld my little piece of plate that I have softened off on the bottom to my piece of Acme threaded rod. So let's go out and look at that, and we'll see if this is going to work. Okay, so here's the piece on the bottom. So this is what I've done is I've softened this off so it's going to allow it to rock and kick in there, and I've got all these edges all softened off really nice, so it's going to flow and be real smooth the way it flows inside there. So I've got a 3/4 inch hole drilled through this piece of 3/8 inch plate, and then I beveled it back really good with the die grinder, and I'm just going to give myself a nice weld in here. I cleaned this off real good on the wire wheel to make sure that there was no oil or anything. And once I get this welded together, then I'll go ahead and cut this off, just because, you know, I wanted something a little bit longer to hold on to. So I've got a block of wood that I checked for squareness pinned to the table, and so I pinned it up this way, which I know is square, and then I used one of my other squares to check it to the bottom of the table. And so I feel very confident that I have this piece of Acme threaded rod in here very, very square and held in place for me to weld it. So let me weld this guy up, and then I'll cut it off, and it should be ready to go. Okay, so here's the... It's still a little hot. I cooled it with water, but it's a little hot. And then ran it on the belt sander. But there is the... Here's the thing welded completely, and then you know, kind of ground flat. So I think that's going to work real well. So let me go ahead and just put this in here. I want to give myself about a solid 1/8 inch at the bottom. And you can see there's my center line. So, you know, I want to give myself, line that up to the center there, and then just go ahead and cut that off back. I don't think it's going to move up. I think if anything, it's going to move this way. But I'll go ahead and I should probably just make it equal on both. But I think it's going to be just fine. Something like that. Let me get my square and I want to put my center line to that, and then I'll go ahead and cut it off. All right. Here's what I think my final shape is going to be. Almost looks like an airplane wing, but there'll be no lift in this. But this is going to allow, you know, so primarily the force is going to be pulling against that plate, and but if it does bottom out, it can seat on that too. It's very sloppy and loose in here. This is all going to get finished, and I'll pop some grease in there too. But so this is going to allow this. I think that's way more tilt than it's ever going to need. It's probably going to be something about like this, but I went ahead and relieved this backside too, so it won't pull on the plate. But this plate has a, you know, we'll go in here like this, and it has a corresponding mating plate on the backside, and there'll be a big 5/16 bolt going all the way through and catching that back plate. So the chances of this pulling out, it's just going to depend on whether my fit is right. And here you can see that it can allow this, and then well beyond. That's probably, I probably went completely overboard with that, but that's okay. But you know, that's going to be where hopefully it's going to stay. But then it can move here. So looking good, I like it. I'll polish the backside of this, and then after I finish everything, I'll put a little grease on the inside, and it'll should work real well.